Welcome back. In this lesson, I'm going to cover cloud computing deployment models. So deployment models are different to service models. The service models are infrastructure as a service, platform as a service, and software as a service, and then some variations of those different models. Now we're talking about deployment. So we're talking about private cloud, public cloud, hybrid, and you can see the different options here. So private cloud is where you're deploying the infrastructure in your own data center, and then you have to have the relevant software layers on top to make it a cloud service. Things like the metered billing, as well as the service catalog. So we can build these a variety of ways. There's different vendors who offer the software layers to sit on top of the hardware, and they include VMware, Microsoft, Red Hat, and OpenStack. And then, of course, we've got the public cloud. That's mostly what we've been concerned with in this course. We're talking about AWS, but other ones are Microsoft Azure and Google Cloud Platform. Those are the three biggest. There are others, of course, as well. Now, hybrid cloud is just where we're connecting our clouds together, public and private. And multi-cloud is where we're using two or more of these different offerings at a time. So let's have a look visually. So private cloud is where we've built our infrastructure layer. We've got our virtualization clusters. We've got our storage and backup systems. We've got our networking and communication devices and potentially some firewalls in there as well. So we're going to build and manage this cloud deployment in our data center. And then we need to layer on top of this some capabilities through software. So here we have a service catalog and a self-service portal. We've got some configuration management, billing and reporting, and multi-tenancy, and there's other components as well. We need to provide those capabilities on top of the infrastructure layer in order to make this a true private cloud. Benefits here are that we get complete control of the entire stack. We can build it exactly to our requirements. Security can be a benefit here. Now, the public cloud has a huge amount of security built into it. In fact, it's very hard to replicate the levels of security that AWS implement. However, in some cases, you might need to have full control of every layer of the stack. And the only way you can do that is in your own data center. So there are some situations where security is a benefit when we're looking at private cloud as compared to the public cloud. So we've got examples like running VMware. They have their vCloud suite. We've got Microsoft with Hyper-V and the various layers of software you can place on top. And Red Hat and OpenStack also provide some cloud management software. So then we have the public cloud. So the public cloud is a cloud service where, of course, multiple customers, multiple organizations are utilizing this, and anyone really can sign up and start using the public cloud. Now, we might be using it across the internet directly. We might be connecting our corporate office either through the internet, like a virtual private network connection or a private link. Now, if we do that, it becomes a hybrid cloud. If we provide that sort of connectivity at the network layer from our office or data center into the public cloud, especially if we're deploying some infrastructure locally in the data center as well and providing that cross communication. Now, in the public cloud, we can deploy various services. Of course, there's hundreds of different services in the public cloud. In terms of benefits, with the public cloud, we have that variable expense. So it's an OPEX, an operational expenditure, rather than a capital expenditure or CAPEX cost. Rather than spending large quantities of cash building our own systems, we're just spending on a monthly basis based on what we use. And then we have economies of scale. So the public cloud can be very cost effective. The fact that AWS has created such a large infrastructure and created the software capabilities and the services which so many customers can use means that they can lower the price to you. Doesn't mean it's always cheaper. In some cases, using a private cloud can be cheaper for certain applications and certain workloads. But don't forget to factor in all the operational costs, the security, the data center, and all those sorts of aspects as well. And then we have massive amounts of elasticity. In the public cloud, it's almost limitless. If you scale your business really quickly, there's capacity there for you. Very hard to replicate that, if not impossible, in a private cloud situation. So here, of course, we have AWS, Azure, Google Cloud Platform, and other providers as well. So the hybrid is what we saw before, but where we're actually connecting our data center and the cloud. So not just the people in the office, but we now actually have the full data center and whatever applications we have in our data center on premises connected into the public cloud with a connection, which again can be a virtual private network over the internet, or it can be a private link like AWS Direct Connect. So here we can choose where to put our applications. Some might make sense in the data center, some might make more sense in the public cloud. and we can leverage different services for our various applications as well, like SaaS services or platform as a service or IaaS in the cloud. Maybe we even just use it as a burst capacity or a backup. That's what some organizations do. We can also easily move data and applications and services between these different deployment models because we've set up this connectivity between them as well. Lastly, we have multi-cloud. This is becoming a lot more common. All this really means is that a company is finding the need to leverage multiple public and private cloud services. They might find that some applications they prefer to deploy into Azure. Maybe that's because one of the development teams in part of the company are more interested in .NET and they like to use PowerShell and they're used to the Microsoft stack. Or maybe you just prefer the identity features and integration into Office 365, for example. Other applications might make more sense in the AWS cloud, so they put some in there as well. And then they might even have multiple private clouds built on VMware, OpenStack, and other providers. And they've got full connectivity between these different clouds. That's a multi-cloud environment, and it means you get the best of these different clouds. Of course, that does increase complexity, so it's not always the best for things like security or operational efficiency, but it is quite a common scenario today.